So let's move to the second video. If you have not watched, check the information card here. The first video where we talked about the job search, internship and thesis and all other things in Germany. So for the second video, the topic of discussion is survival guide in Germany. So it's like the so he has already stayed in Germany for more than three years,
right.
So that's why he knows all the tips, bits, tricks and everything that you normally get to experience after you start living there and optimize and save money and offers and all these kind of things. We are going to discuss very briefly, like touch upon some points, and all the links that we discuss, we may not mention it here, will be in the description. So do watch and read the description below, and you can always contact him. His contact will be in the description. So maybe you can start.
Yeah. So survival guide is when you first step in Germany. So there are a lot of things you will do. So if you are going for an higher study, then you will always have a welcome. They say international students welcome. So they will always tell you what to do, what are the administrative things that you need to do, and what are the legal stuffs you need to remember. So they will always guide you, and it's always good to talk to your international person. Or the person responsible for talking to you regarding this, whatever problems international students have in that area.
Okay.
So it's always good to talk to them, to know the legal things. So I will keep it short and tell you that the first thing you need to do when you come to Germany is that do your city registration, go for registration for your health insurance, and that's all. Basically, that's two things that you need to do, because once you do the city registration,
then you can open the bank
account. You can open the bank account, and also you will receive a social security number.
BSN. It's not called BSN. It's in Netherlands. It's similar to social security number.
Everyone, I guess, even in France, they have this social security thing. So you need that, because you need that number whenever you go for any part time or anything. So you can do that. So this is the first thing, and then about the cost. So the cost, many a times people ask me that what is the cost of living. So let me tell you, the cost of living is always area specific. So where you live in, so if you live in Munich, just be prepared that it will cost like 1000 euros around per month. Yeah,
including everything.
Everything. And if it is like places outskirts, like I was from Bremerhaven, I was living in Bremerhaven, studying in Bremerhaven. So Bremerhaven is like an outskirts city from Bremen. So there the cost of living was less. So we could survive like at 450 or 500 euros. It depends. It depends on your lifestyle also. So, but it's area specific, but it's always good to keep in mind that you need to spend like 850 euros a month. It keeps on changing. It is always updated in the German embassy site. So one must always keep a look on it. About the spendings. So when you come, it's always difficult to find the cheap shops. So I will tell you what are the cheap shops you can have. One is the 1 euro shop. It's called Ein Euro Shop or Euro Shop. In Germany, it is also so there is Euro Shop, and another one is the Teddy Shop.
Okay.
So what is there inside is that everything they have is costing 1 euro, or in Teddy Shop it can be 2 euros, but that's maximum I have seen until now.
Okay.
So it depends, and these things you can buy. Let's say you want to buy a bucket, or maybe buy a bucket for your dustbin, or maybe some kitchen items, let's say plates or something like that, or maybe glasses and stuff. Or mugs, coffee mugs, everything you
the
can get.
Daily utilities.
Yes, even the stationary items.
Okay.
Even the stationary items. So this is one shop, and another is Woolworth. So it's WOOL.
Yeah, we'll leave it in the description below all the links.
So it's Woolworth. There you can go to buy some cheap clothes and also stationary items. If someone is someone wants to have files or maybe papers or something like that, you can get it for cheap there. And the third thing is that Primark. So you have Primark even in Netherlands.
Also in Belgium, I've seen.
Yes, and in France. I've seen people in France.
So then maybe it's in most... So it's like a UK company, but because most of the things are produced in China, Bangladesh, India, or some Asian countries where their labor is very cheap. So the products are really cheap. For my experience, if you buy some daily use stuff, it's okay. If you want to buy something high-end stuff and you find it in cheap price in Primark, it may be good. It may not be that of good quality.
Yeah, it all depends. But if you want like some t-shirts for your daily use, like for nightwear or maybe like the casual t-shirt, so you can always buy it from Primark.
Like this t-shirt is like 3 euros or 2.5 euros from Primark, so
so it all like that. And eating, if you want to eat outside, I would always consider not to eat outside so frequently, because you will lose a lot of money. Because I know a lot of people come with very with very humble background, and and they are not,
and they are not like middle class, as we call in India, like we are not that spend that lavishly.
Yes, exactly. So we haven't led a lavish life in India, and we cannot spend a lot. So in
there's
that case,
a lot of pressure of the finance.
It's always good to cook your own food. Cook your own food every day. Maybe sometimes it will be a little bit boring, but you should cook every day. You will always find Indian
store. Maybe find groups, and sometimes on weekend you can go together and group your own meal and eat together. Sometimes it happens a lot. Like.
Yeah, you can do that. So these are the things I would say that will save a lot of money.
Okay.
A lot of money it will save. So yeah, hopefully this helps.
Yeah. And we'll leave all the description links in the description below, and maybe some more links depending on. Do smash the like button if you like this video. Don't forget to share this video among your friends, and subscribe to the channel if you have not subscribed yet, so that you keep getting this content about studying and living in Europe, Netherlands, Germany, Belgium, and other places.
Yep. Thank you very much.
So till next video, see you. Bye bye.
Peace out.